follow Raj Baddhan on Twitter and Facebook. Simply search for Raj Baddhan.
Taken from the film Humpty Shadamagi Lania, a very cool set. I'm Shrey Ghoshal, sounding so good with Arijit Singh. Amate Nuki Sam Java. That's the question, isn't it? Get that Sam Java. Get us Sam Java. Oh ho. But one thing that I can say, the lady I got next on my show, she's easy to Sam Java. Sachi Muchi. I'm so excited because it has been ages since I've had her on Drivetime.
Star Drive with Raj Baddhan on Drivetime.
And she's looking a million bucks these days. Have you checked out Instagram? I was checking them and I was in awe of all the pictures. Anything like the... I'm talking about Krystle D’Souza, who is back here on Drivetime. Hi, Krystle.
Hi, Raj.
Hello. Krystle, it's been ages.
Hello. First of all, that was my favorite song, Main Tainu Samjhaava Ki. It's my favorite song of all time.
Is it? See, so I had this
last night and tripping over it all over again.
Oh, wow.
Yay!
It was one of those things. I was thinking, okay, how am I going to introduce Krystle? And I thought, let me play something romantic. So there you go. That song was for you, right?
Hi.
How are you? How you been? Now, last time I spoke to you, I think it was since Ek Nahi Pehchan, when you were starting that. And it's been that's been about a year since it wrapped up. Now, how you been since then?
I've been fantastic. Aren't you seeing my Instagram? Aren't you seeing my Twitter? I've been all over the place.
I've
been traveling and keeping it very real. And, you know, I'm loving chilling with my real friends and my family and all of it. So it's a good time off.
Okay, awesome. I was thinking, I go, pata nahi kya ho gaya hai. I was going to get you for an interview when you start a new show, but I thought, yeah, show pata nahi kab shuru hoga. So I thought, let me just get you on the show and let's just do a catch up.
Don't you see the holiday glow on my face?
I do. I mean, that's what I was saying to you off air. I go, you are looking so good these days. I don't know what it is. It is a holiday. That's definitely working. But just generally. Some jar, please, some jar. Maybe I need some of your beauty tips or some kind of inspiration that you're working on you, because you are looking so good. But Krystle, I mean, when are we going to see you back on screen? When is it going to be that you're going to sign a new show?
2016 it is. I am going to start looking for a show now. I wasn't looking for a show. I wasn't looking at getting back for acting or on screen last year. But this year it is. I'm going to get back to work and going to get myself occupied again.
I couldn't help but I noticed a picture of you and Ekta Kapoor together the other day. I was thinking, is something brewing over here? Kuch ya ho raha hai?
Other than pure friendship, nothing else. I don't like to mix friendship with work.
Yeah.
Never.
Uh-huh.
That's not my style.
Okay.
But I love her. She's a superb person. She's very genuine. She's a child at heart. And I actually feel like I'm chilling with a friend. She's somebody that's really, really close to me. So nothing professionally going on with Ekta. But of course, she's one of my dearest and closest friends.
Yeah, no, the picture was amazing. Just like the rest of them on Instagram. Okay, so have you thought about kind of the roles you would like to take up on? And also scripts, have you been reading many? I mean, since Ek Nahi Pehchan ended?
Yeah, there are a lot of scripts that have come my way, but nothing that was very different from Jivika or Sakshi, and I really want to do something different. I do want to play the main protagonist, but something that is a little more challenging as an actor for me. So no more Bichari Bahu and no more woman empowering Bahu. Some new Bahu.
but the direction of Indian television is changing quite a bit. Even lately, there's been quite a few shows.
I have to become a Nagin, I think.
Yeah, you have to become a Nagin. It's a number one show in India. That is crazy, isn't it? It's some of these old formats that are coming back in fashion as well.
Yeah. It's everything. All the Mytho shows and all of that was doing really big in 2015. And I really genuinely have nothing against Mytho shows or, all these kind of shows. Just that I won't be able to do it and I don't think I fit the bill. So I took a back seat.
Mm-hmm.
So 2016, okay. I'm going to look for something young, something fun and something interesting to do.
Oh, I can't wait for that. I know because you were telling me before that you're working and you're talking to a few of these producers and stuff. But I can't wait for the confirmation. So do let us know when that is going to be, all right?
Of course, you'll be the first one to know.
Oh, thank you. Krystle, so how's other things? I mean, how's Karan? I spoke to Karan when he was here in London last. Have you been seeing him often these days? I mean, how's things with him?
Of course, he's my only friend.
Achcha.
So, I I've seen him very often. Yes, he's doing fantastic. He's looking good as well, right? Don't you see his Instagram as well?
He
making
is.
Making his body and stuff.
He's spending a lot of time in the gym.
He's doing really well. He's doing good. And yeah, I meet him a lot.
Okay. And also, 8 years in the industry for you, Krystle. So, eight years. How has that been for you? What's been like the highlight for you in these 8 years?
I think, of course, Ek Hazaar Mein Meri Pehna has been my highlight for these 8 years. These 8 years, I've worked continuously. I've done so many shows back to back. I was working the time I was 17. So I've done a lot of shows back to back. This 1 year break that I took, I think I really deserved it. So, it's been a great 8 years, but I think Jivika is the closest. I'm going to be a little picky and choosy and say I love Jivika. I watch my episodes even today and I fall in love with the character.
Oh, do you still watch it? I mean, do you still watch it online every now and then? Just see those memories?
Yeah,
from it,
whenever I go on YouTube, because I stream so much of Viren Jivika VMs and stuff like that, they pop up, episodes pop up, and I watch a scene or two. And I actually fall in love with Ranji and Jivika and Manvi and all the characters all over again.
Oh, talk about Manvi. Are you still in touch with Nia and Kushal as well?
It's funny, I haven't met Kushal since the day the show got over.
Okay.
But Nia, yeah, I bump into. I bump into, and we're not like people who hang out together, but when we meet, we are a house on fire. We really miss each other a lot, and sometimes we pick up the phone and call each other saying, I miss you, Kutti.
Oh.
But I'm not somebody who gets out of the house and goes out partying very often. So that's not, you will not find me partying and, meeting all these people very often. But I've met Nia. Yesterday was Anjali's birthday, so I went to Anjali's house and celebrated with her. So, I think I meet Anjali, I meet the entire cast very often. I haven't met Kushal ever since the day the show got over. So, that's that. Never even bumped into him. So surprising.
Krystle, there's one more question as well about your past shows, Ek Nahi Pehchan. Recently, there was this kind of gathering, wasn't there, that Poonam Dhillon had organized. But you weren't there. Where were you?
I was there. I was the one clicking the picture.
Were you there? Oh, sorry. I didn't realize.
Because
there was one picture. I think that was one that you weren't in. I was thinking, where are you
gone? I'll send you the picture. There's one picture with me in it as well. I had work commitments. I had to go to the launch of Tele Calendar after. So I left a little early.
Achcha.
But I was the first one to enter the party. And I left around 11:30 at night to attend another work. A commitment. So I had to leave early, but I love that show and I love everybody in the show. I think we have a group of our own that's called ENP Family, and we chat every day on it.
There are a lot of fans, in fact, even today, that were contacting, asking.
So I don't miss any gathering. It's just that I'm not somebody who would post a lot of pictures with my friends. You'll see a lot of selfies of mine, because that is not intruding into my personal life. That's just something that I do to keep myself and my fans entertained. But every day I meet a lot of people. I don't post pictures with them because it's intruding into their lives and mine. So I just keep my life a little private as much as I can.
But your Instagram is like a story of its own, isn't it? It's like a whole story of pictures of what you do on a daily basis, which is really good because the fans are loving it. And is it 600,000 followers you got on Instagram? How does that make you feel?
Ooh, that makes me feel fantastic. I don't know how so many people I'm so fast. It just increases 1,000 a day, and I'm surprised. I'm shocked and I'm overwhelmed. But yeah, my Instagram, even my Facebook has crossed 2 million. I don't know how this is happening, but I must be doing something right.
It's brilliant. Absolutely amazing. I think you're just a little bit undermined with the kind of popularity that you got, especially worldwide. And you haven't been on screen, but there's a lot of people that are missing you on TV. And I think once that happens, your popularity will be shooting back up again. Not that it isn't already, but it'll be shooting back up. So, Krystle, come back quick, all right?
Right, it never went down. To start shooting back up, but it's going to go higher.
Yeah, higher and higher, exactly. We're going to take it higher and higher.
Yeah.
Krystle, you know what? There's a lot of questions from the fans. Let's keep these short, right? So start with a question from Zahin, who wants to ask you, what's your New Year's resolution? Are you the kind of person to keep New Year's resolutions?
I try. I fail every year. Last year, I wanted to be fit. I wasn't. This year, it's to stop biting my lips. Whenever I get very nervous, or whenever I'm thinking I keep biting my lips, I'm going to try and stop that.
Oh no! Okay, why do you bite your lips?
I don't know. I get nervous. I bite my lips. I don't know what I get out of it.
Okay, there's a question here also from Shani. Shani, and she's asking, if you were to choose one, which Krystle would you choose? Krystle D’Souza as a superstar or Krystle D’Souza as a normal girl, and why?
I think Krystle D’Souza as a normal girl who becomes a star and still remains normal, because I think becoming a star doesn't change the person that you are. You have to just be a normal person. I mean, you're no different. Becoming a star is just your job. Yeah. It shouldn't change you. So I think Krystle D’Souza is normal, because I think I'm fun.
Yeah, no, definitely you are. And even here, when you were in the UK and in Leicester with us, we had so much fun. And you are a fun girl.
I'm a little bubbly person.
You are. And that's the kind of people we're like having around. So it was amazing having you around. Don't you miss Leicester? There's a few people asking, when are you going to be coming back to Leicester and the UK?
I want to. Right now it's too cold. I don't think I'd be able to take it, because it's going to be really, really cold. But I want to come there. So mid this year, I'm going to be in London for sure, because I miss London too much.
Awesome.
Too much.
Can't wait for that.
Last May.
Yeah. By the way, Shani's birthday is on the 18th of January, and she says, can you please wish her happy birthday?
Of course. Happy birthday, Shani. Have a superb and a mind-blowing 2016.
Rupani,
it's difficult to say 16 as
it
yet.
Is. I mean, even me, I was writing a few letters out earlier and I was doing 2015. I'm still getting this kind of date year mixed up. Rupani, Aishu Rupani is asking, what makes Krystle a positive person and how does she deal with negativity?
As much as I can, I avoid it. I don't even look in a direction that says anything close to negativity. I'm very positive about every situation. Even if I'm in the worst situation, I look at it very positively. Only because I think my mom has always taught me that there is every cloud has a silver lining, you know. So look at the silver lining and hope for that happier day that will come, because your bad days are the ones that make you feel happier on your happy days. So that's my only positive mantra, that if today is bad, I know I'm going to be happier tomorrow, that I'm going to have a good day.
I like that. That's good. Mansi's asking about the secret behind your beauty. Would you be Patel?
Secret behind my beauty? nothing, yeah. Some filters on Instagram.
No, you're not. I mean, come on. I mean, I've seen you in real life and you don't use filters in real life.
I like smiling a lot. I like laughing. I like showing 32 teeth. I like showing the world I have each and every one of them. So I think smiling, laughing just keeps you happy from inside and outside. So I think that's the secret. Yeah, just be happy genuinely and it's going to show on your face.
Yeah. Zera is asking, have you got any plans of doing any reality TV shows? Maybe Jalat Diklancha this year?
Hopefully if I do a show, like a television show, then I will do a Jalat Diklancha. Then it only makes sense to do a Jhalak Dikhlaja while I'm doing a show, because I will need that kind of audience to vote for me and stuff. So yes, if I do a television show, then I will do Jhalak Dikhlaja.
All right. Tanisha is asking, one thing about you that no one knows about you, not even Google. Is there anything that you like to tell us?
One thing about me that no one knows about me. I think if till date no one found out about me, then they shouldn't know. But I guess nobody knows that, many people don't know that my middle name is Karishma, and my name Krystle wasn't kept by my parents, it was kept by my godmother. So this is something that I think people don't know.
That is brilliant. So that's like an exclusive. So your middle name is Karishma. Areva.
Yes.
I like that.
Anyway,
okay.
That's the name my mother wanted to keep for me.
And that is, I mean, Krystle is beautiful, but Karishma is, well, a different name completely. I love that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's Krystle Krishma D’Souza, is it?
Krishma D’Souza, yes.
Brilliant. Okay, there's a question also from Mariam asking, which is the best pickup line used on her? Yaniku, is there any kind of lines that have been used on you when you're out and about? I'm sure you've had loads.
I don't know the best, because I don't really like pickup lines. I like a normal conversation. Like if somebody comes up to me and is genuine enough and makes a normal conversation, I like that. So best I won't say, but worst I have, weird person came up to me a few years ago and said, hey, you know what, I'm a little problem. I said, what happened? So he said, I've lost my number, can I have yours?
Oh god.
What? Are you serious? Are you even for real?
Oh god,
get out of my face.
It is, it's cringe worthy. I mean, some of these shut up lines are like, oh man, please don't open your gob again.
And I was genuinely worried for the guy. He looked upset.
Oh, no. God, embarrassing. Embarrassing. I'm glad you gave him a chingi tala jawab, so he's not going to be saying that line again to another girl.
Yeah, I gave
him tala jawab. Okay, Flying 317 is asking, what are the three things that you can't live without?
My phone, first, because my entire world, my family, my friends, my Instagram, my Twitter, my entire world is connected to it through my phone. Then I guess the internet, because without that I wouldn't be able to use my phone. And my mother. I think without her support and love, I wouldn't be able to do anything that I do today.
Rabina is asking, what's the one most special thing that Karan has done for you in 2015 that sticks out?
In 2015, I mean, that guy really makes most of my days special. So he's somebody that's very emotional. I mean, it doesn't come across like that, but he's an emotional, nice, sweet, genuine person. So he makes sure almost every second day is special. Yeah, I mean, I don't have many friends. I don't hang out with a lot of people. So any little thing that anybody does for me is special. And he's the most special himself.
Oh, I can feel it. I can feel the pyar. So there you go, Krystle. I love that. It's not pyar. It's that kind of like a Bollywood film. It's that aduri prem kahani. So let's see what happens.
I thought we're keeping it short, Raj.
We are. We're finishing in 5 minutes. All right. And also, Cindy's asking, would you ever think about doing any negative roles?
I did a negative role. I did a negative role a few years ago called Veera on Star Plus in a show called Kis Desh Mein Hai Mera Dil. Didn't work for me because I don't think I have a negative face anymore. I was a kid at that time, so I looked like a brat. But right now, I don't have a negative face to pull off something so negative. So, no, I'm going to stick to positive. I don't really think negative is my scene. But I would love to play a character for a few days, maybe that turns negative, because you get to do so much more than a positive character.
I agree. Yeah, that's good. There's a question also from Raksha asking you, have you ever thought about hosting? Of course, Karan recently hosted The Voice. What about you? As a host, maybe?
I don't know. I don't think I can host, because I'm not that witty. I'm not that funny. I don't have that kind of sense of humor like Karan does, maybe. So and all your hosts, your Manish Paul, all of them, they can be funny, they can do things, they can roll over the stage. I don't think I can do that, you know.
Oh.
So for being a host, I think being funny on Indian television is very important.
Indeed.
So I don't think I can be very funny. I'm not a very funny person.
You should give it
a matter of fact person.
You should give it a try. I think you surprise many. You know that. I think
I can do it with somebody who is doing most of the funny stuff, and I can stand there and doll up and smile.
Nagaratana is asked. It's basically saying hello to you, and she says she can't wait to have you back, and she's asking, will you be visiting Hyderabad anytime soon?
Nagaratna.
Yes.
I think I've seen that name. No, I won't be visiting Hyderabad, but I would love to. Yeah, I would love to have the biryani there and kebabs there. I've heard they're lovely. So if I come there, I'll let her know on social media.
Tika. And Prishni is asking, what's the hardest part of being a celebrity?
You can't go out to a mall and shop.
Yeah, I can imagine
that. On a weekend, it's very, very, very difficult to go to a mall. And you know all your sales happen on a weekend. And I live across the mall, but I can't enter it because it gets really crazy. So I think just going out for films with your friends without getting clicked, you can't look like how you look like when you wake up from your bed, because you have to always look presentable, because someone's going to click a selfie with you somewhere.
Yeah, or the paparazzi will just shoot you. So there you go. You've got to be careful with that. Okay, there's a few highs here. Hi to Illy, Dipiksha, Nagaratna, who we just mentioned, Aditi, Savneet, Ishka, Zera, Ironika, Siddhi, Mira, Chetna, Maheen, Arman, and that's it. There's quite a few hellos, hi. So all of them, hello from you.
Hi, guys. And I only heard one guy's name in that. That's Arman. So hi, all you pretty girls. And hi, Arman.
By the way, it's Arman's birthday soon as well. So we need to say happy birthday to him. He's going to be 16 very soon. So wishing him a happy birthday.
Wow, you're going to be sweet 16, Arman. Really, really. Happy birthday to you. Have a superb year and get older sooner, yeah. Live life.
Oh. And finally, Norsheen said, today's my little sister Nishat's 12th birthday and she's a huge fan of Krystle D’Souza. Can you please say happy birthday to Nishat?
To?
Nishat.
Nishat, wish you a very, very, very happy birthday. Have a beautiful year again and all the best to enter your teens. I think this is a crucial time in life. So 13 is coming up soon.
Oh, do you know what, Krystle? Yeah, I could talk to you forever. I can, seriously, but the news is coming and I know you got to go as well. But it has been so good having you back here on the radio. But now keep in touch. We will definitely be seeing you soon on television. Have you got one final message for all the listeners and all your fans out there? There's so many worldwide that are listening to this interview.
First of all, it was lovely speaking to you, Raj, and I've spoken to you after really long, so very happy about that. And to everyone out there, thank you so much for still loving me and still being so patient with me. And I'm going to come up with a bang in 2016. Watch out.
Wow, sounds like a demarca indeed. So Krystle D’Souza has promised us that it's going to be an explosion this year with the next project that she works on. So Krystle, looking forward to that and definitely keep us posted. All right.
Alright.
Thank you so much. But thank you. And look after yourself. Take care. Back at you. Alright. Take care. Bye.
Bye.
There you go. That is the adorable Krystle D’Souza live here on the radio. Oh man. So good to have her back. By the way, if you missed that interview, you can listen back to it at subridgeradio.com after 6 o'clock this evening at subridgeradio.com. Alright. We're on the way for you next. Back to some more hits. After the news at 5.
1260 AM. Digital. Online. Mobile app.
This is Sabres Radio.
From the Sky News Centre at 5, the Health Secretary is urging...